Welcome student, in our second lecture on chili crop. In last lecture we studied on transplanting of chili seedlings into the main field. Then we studied the other remaining points, that is, first one is the intercultivation. There is a gap filling. Number second, weeding. Number next, hoeing. And number four is the earthing up. These are interculture operations are given to the chili crop after the transplanting. So, first we study the gap filling. This operation is given to maintain the optimum plant population per hectare or per unit area in order to get maximum higher yield from the field. So, this operation is given after 10 to 15 days of transplanting time. So, initially, after the transplanting of chili seedlings, it is well established within 7 to 10 days, and so that this gap filling operation is given in between the 10 to 15 days of plant transplanting time. In case of kharif season crop, gap filling operation is given after 3 weeks of transplanting time. So, where seedlings are failed to establish or seedlings are established but it is disease, that seedlings are removed. And where seedlings are failed to development, that spot only one healthy treated seedlings are planted without damage the root system, and care should be taken that the small quantity of urea should be applied into the pit during the gap filling to make an equal growth of all seedlings into the field. Then we study the weeding. Generally 2 to 3 weedings are sufficient to the chili crop, and it is important that the field is kept weedless or field is kept clean, always kept clean to reduce the attack of pest and disease. So, first hand weeding is given after 15 days of transplanting time, and next sub hand weedings are given at the interval of 3 to 4 weeks up to the flowering stage. All interculture operations are completed before the flowering stage, because during the flowering stage, when interculture operations are given, that time flower seeding or flower dropping take place. So, avoid the flower dropping. All interculture operations are completed before the flowering stage. Next one is the sometime hoeings are also given when it is planted as a flatbed method. It helps to loosening of soil, uprooted the excess weed plant between the empty space or between two rows. So, this operation also helps to conserve the soil moisture and allow to penetration of roots. And it will also give light soil support to the plant. And at the time of each hand weeding, care should be taken that the all light soil support is given to the plant at the time of each hand weeding. Generally, next point we study the earthing up in chili. This operation help to well stand the chili plants into the field and reduce the damage against the wind, breaking of branches, or due to heavy weight of chili fruits. Sometimes, if there is a heavy weight of chili plant due to fruits, support is given to the bamboos that help reduce the damage against the loading of chili plants. So this operation is given mainly for irrigated crop. In case of irrigated crop, this operation is given before the flowering stage. Soil support is given to the plant and it also avoid the damage or avoid the contact of water and plant stem, so that the reduce the developing of soil-borne fungus diseases. So this operation is important. Or sometime due to heavy rainfall, chili plants are loaded on ground, so that the in that condition earthing up operation is more helpful. So it is given before the flowering stage. Generally, there are near about 25% flower shedding take place by naturally, but due to interculture operations during the flowering stage, it lead the more dropping of flowers and it affect on the developing of chili fruits, or it will become less. So the all interculture operations are completed before the flowering stage or during the flowering stage. Next one is the manuring. Generally, 10 to 15 tons FYM per hectare. Mix with soil properly during the land preparation time, and harrowings are given to well mix the FYM into the soil. The fertilizer dose for rainfield chili crop is 40 to 50 kg nitrogen, 30 to 40 kg phosphorus, and 30 to 40 kg potash per hectare. And the recommended fertilizer dose for irrigated crop is 80 to 90 kg nitrogen, 40 to 50 kg phosphorus, and 40 to 50 kg potash per hectare. All phosphorus and potash should be given at the time of transplanting or before the transplanting as a basal dose. And nitrogen is given to equal spilt or doses. First dose is given after 15 days of transplanting time. That time seedlings are well established. And second dose is given during the flowering stage. And it is given as a nitrogen fertilizer dose is given as a ring method around the plant. And after that, the fertilizer covered with soil. The excess use of nitrogenous fertilizer lead the more branching or vegetative growth of plant and also increase the attack of cells of sucking pest like thrips, white fly, which results or which transmit the viral diseases. So excess use of nitrogenous fertilizer is avoided. Next one point we study, the irrigation management. In case of kharif season crop, chili crop thrives very well on available soil moistures during the rainy season. So it has no required extra irrigation water, but care should be taken that due to heavy rainfall during the rainy season, excess rainwater immediately drain out from the field by opening drainage canals, that the chili crop does not well stand in water stagnation condition. Next one is the next one point should be also we write down as a, if there is a long dry spell between two rains, two protective irrigations are given at critical growth stage, that the flowering stage and fruit development stage. It help the yield of chili fruit increase. Then the when it is grown as a irrigated crop during the rabi and summer season, that time pre-soaking irrigation is given in light soils. First pre-soaking irrigation is given in light soil before the transplanting or at the time of transplanting, or in heavy soil, seedlings are planted in a dry condition and after that immediately given light irrigation water to the field. So in after that, the next sub irrigations are given at the interval of 15 to 20 days during the rabi season. Excess or a heavy application of irrigation is avoided. Then the in case of in rabi season crop, interval should be taken 8 to 10 days and critical growth stages of chili crop is the transplanting stage, number second flowering stage, number third fruit development stage. So above mentioned critical growth stages, lack of moisture results reduce the yield of chili fruit. So proper or moderate moisture content should be available into the field while chili crop is grown. Then we study the harvesting. The harvesting of chili crop is depend upon the purpose of cultivation, that the sometimes green chilies are also harvested, or sometimes crops should be planted for red chili harvesting. So these two points are carefully keep in your mind while the writing of harvesting point in chili. The time of chili harvesting is depends upon the type of variety and type of soil. Generally, green chilies are starts. Green chilies are starts 90 days after transplanting. So it is the right stage when the which chili fruits are ripen or matured, not ripen but matured or full developed. They only these only well developed or matured chili fruits are picked from the plant. Only green color chilies are only green color and fully developed chilies are picked at the interval of 10 days and fresh chilies are packed in a gunny bag and transported to the market immediately. and picking of green chilies starts after 90 days and it extends up to the 3 month. Then the red chilies are harvested after 105 days, that is the 105 days after transplanting. It is picking of red chilies is done at the interval of 10 to 15 days, 3 to 4 times in case of rainfield crop, and in case of irrigated crop it is harvested or 5 to 6 pickings are taken. Then the chili fruits are, while the chili fruits are harvested, the same care should be taken that the it is pick or cut or separate from the plant along with its stalk, because when chili fruit have no stalk, that time it is not well stored or keeping quality is reduced during the storage condition. So these points are carefully study or listen. Then the average yield of green chilies is the 80 to 90 quintals per hectare, and average yield of red chilies for rainfield crop 5 to 6 quintal per hectare, and irrigated condition it is the 15 to 20 quintals per hectare. The recovery rate of chilies is 25 to 30% of the fresh weight of green chilies. So these points are carefully studied. Then we study the drying of chilies. The pick of red chilies are dried in a sun on the floor for 4 to 5 days, and care should be taken that the chilies are harvested along with its stalk and it is spread on a ground surface for sunlight in a thin layer for uniform drying and get good color or better good red color. The chili fruits are stirred daily 2 to 3 times, that the alternate the layer 2 to 3 times in a day. Then the sometimes chili fruits are artificially dry at 50 degrees Celsius to 54 degrees Celsius temperature for 2 to 3 days. Dried chilies are graded according to their color and size. Then the chilies are packed in a gunny bags and market. While gradation of chili that time yellow color or dark black color, chilies are separated on and only red color chilies are stored into the gunny bags and transport to the market. Immature chilies develop yellowish color and should not be stored well during the storage condition. So green chilies are not harvest. Good quality chilies can be obtained from first two picking in rainfield crop and up to the 4 pickings in case of irrigated crop. The healthy, well developed and dried chilies from first two pickings are sorted and used for seed purpose. The color of chilies remain red color of chilies remain up to the more than 5 to 6 months after drying. So immature chili fruits does not harvest. Only red color developed chilies are harvested from the plant and it is used for drying. So these points are also carefully studied. Then we study the pest and diseases of chili, that is the plant protection. There are some important pests, that is the thrips, number second cutworm, number four, third aphids, and number four paper weevil. These are the pests which attack on the chili plant. Then we study the diseases. Disease like dumping off, it is attack on the during the seedling stage in a nursery. Then the dieback disease of chili. Number next, there is anthracnose, and number four, that is the virus disease of chili. So these diseases are also carefully listen or study for our exam. Initially we also ask for thrips on chili for 2 mark short note. The time, nature of damage and control measures should be write down. First we study the pest, that is the thrips. We initially study the nature of damage. It is the most serious or more serious pest of chili crop. Number second, it is the cell sap sucking pest. The nymphs and adults are suck the cell sap from tender leaves, flowers, flower buds, and after that leaves are looks like as a curl or curling leaves are developed due to attack of thrips. So the nymphs and adults suck the cell sap from leaves by scraping epidermis, sucking the azote cell sap, which is poisonous, and after that the infected leaves are turned into brown color, that the leaves are looks like as a curl, which is developed bend upward and downward, and chili plants are fail to develop its further growth and it matured or it exert maturity signs before complete its life cycle. And the severe attack of thrips, it results the transmission of virus disease, which is known as a leaf curl, or locally known as a Surda Murda or Bokra disease of chili. So these points are also carefully listened. The plant growth is retarded, so plants are not developed in the total. If severe attack, it spread whole crop. So these points are carefully studied. Next one is the control measure. Given a spray of 1% Melathion at the interval of 10 days. Apply the 10% forage granules, 10 kg per hectare during the transplanting time, and given a spray of dimethoate 15 ml per 10 liter water at the interval of 10 to 15 days. So this help to reduce the attack of thrips. Next one pest is the cutworm. Cutworm, nature of damage, the caterpillar of this pest remain hid into the soil during the day period and damage the crop during the night hours. So it majorly attack immediately after the transplanting of chili seedlings. It cut the plant at ground level and feed tender part of the plant. Then the many gaps are appeared, and also it feed on tender roots. So many gaps are appeared. So field is looks like as a gappy. Then the control measure apply 5% chlordane or heptachlor dust to the soil at the rate of 50 kg per hectare during the plant preparation while FYM mixing. So these pests are also carefully study or listen. Then the aphids, it is the cell sap sucking pest. It sucks cell sap from the leaves and exert or extract gummy substance from its body, on which develop fungus growth, and laterally leaves are dried and stop the further growth of the plant. So it initially attack on the tender part of plant or tender shoot, then during the flower development or flower bud development stage, it also attack. So the control measures are same as a thrips, and it also lead the transmission of virus diseases, which is known as a leaf curl. Then the paper we will paste, it also ask for our one mark fill in the blank. So it is the attack, the paper we will paste mainly attack on Solanaceae family crop and maggot stage is harmful to the chili plant. It feed on developing blossom and more damage take place or more damage lead by this pest, that is the paper weevil. So it also ask for our one mark fill in the blanks. Paper weevil is the serious pest of dot dot crop. It is the serious pest of chili crop. So these are the pests. This should be carefully listen or study. Then we study the diseases which are attack on the chili crop. Number one, there is a dumping up. The symptoms are the, it is fungus disease of chili crop. It attack or found on seedlings during the nursery management at earlier growth stage of the plant. Initially, brownish water soaked lesions are appeared on the base of stem. Then the shrinking or rotting of affected tissues of stem take place, and then results damage or rotting of the plant or stem take place, and plants are falls down. So this disease majorly attack during the nursery into the heavy application water is applied. So the control measures that the given a seed treatment of Serosan or Agrosan 2.5 gram per kg seeds per 2.5 kg seeds before the sowing of seed in a nursery. Then the given 1% border mixture spray on seedlings at the interval of 15 to 20 days. Then the avoid the crowding or thickly germinated seedlings, that the it is thin out thickly germinated seedling, and water stagnation condition is avoid in nursery. So these are the control measures of dumping of disease. Then we study the Dybeck disease of chili. This disease, it is the fungus disease. This disease observed at the flowering stage of chili crop, drying of branches start from tip to base of stem. So it is known as a Dybeck. Plant branches are suddenly died and the plants are failed to develop the flowers and fruits. So it is the important disease. It also found on the citrus plant, citrus type plant, and it also found in chili. That is known as a Dybeck disease. The control measures are the given a spray of border mixture, that is the proportion is the 2 as 50, that is the number second. Next is the given a set treatment of cervasan or agrosan before the sowing of seeds, that is the 2.5 gram per kg seed. Then we study the anthracnose disease. Anthracnose disease also attack on leaf and also on chili fruits. When it attack on chili fruits, that time outer skin of chili fruit is suddenly rotting and fruits are looks like as a decay or rotten. So this is the important disease. We study the symptoms. Initially, circular brown color sunken spots are appeared on leaves, that the on leaves, stem and fruits. Then the loss of chili fruits is near about 75% due to anthracnose disease of chili. So these points are also carefully studied. Then these spots are enlarged and attach with each other and form a big lesions or make a injury lesions on the leaves and on fruits. So fruits are start to rotten and leaves are also dried or dropping. So these are the symptoms of anthracnose disease, and near about 75% loss of chili fruit lead due to anthracnose disease. Then the control measure, given a seed treatment of agrosan or cervasan 2.5 gram per kg seeds. Then the given a 1% border mixture spray at the interval of 15 to 20 days and use of copper oxychloride at the rate of 25 to 30 gram per 10 liter water, and it is given a foliar spray to control the anthracnose disease. Then we study the leaf curl disease of chili. It is the viral disease of chili crop. Leaves become small due to curling of leaf margins and it bend inward and upward take place. So due to infection of leaf curl virus and severe attack of this disease, leaves are falls down and further growth of plant is stopped, and this disease or viral disease transmit through the aphids and thrips. So these